Presbyterian Church. All are welcome to join us for in-person worship. For those who are not quite ready to return, we offer virtual worship. Our in-person gatherings will be contingent on us meeting all our safety standards and the most current information we have. Updates will be posted weekly. Masks will be required and safety precautions will still be in place. LAPC Health and Safety Plan will be posted throughout the building and is available by way of email upon request. Let us be faithful then to God and to one another. As we receive the gifts and work through the challenges of this time and the life of our congregation and world, let us be guided by the Word, responsive to the Spirit, and open to the grace of God. Let us all work together as we seek to witness the compassion of Christ in this unique time. We are currently looking for volunteers for scripture readings for Sunday morning, and there's those that are in the congregation here this morning on the yellow cloth on the table in the back, you can sign up for June if you're interested. Or you can contact Patty at elmwoodjesus.org for details and to sign up today. Also, our blessing box has been a blessing. I really want to thank the people in the neighborhood that have contributed to the box during this week. When I come in this morning, I checked out the box, and there were a lot of good things in there. People have been putting in potatoes and vegetables and fruits, which is great for the people in our community. The blessing box is an outdoor food pantry sponsored by Lafayette and the Elmwood Village community. It will be stocked with non-perishable food items, basic toiletries, baby supplies, and anything else that might be considered a blessing to someone who finds themselves in need. Items are anonymously donated and anonymously received, located on the Lafayette side of the church. One bad mouth can be enough to plunge a household into food insecurity. Feed your people. For more details on Lafayette, you can check us out on our website, elmwoodjesus.org, as well as Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Thank you, and God bless you.
Let us share the call to worship. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in holy array. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon to skip like a cat, and Syria like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the oaks to whirl, and strips the forest bare, and in his temple all cry, glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace.
Thank you. darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone who does evil hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he who does what is true comes to the light, that it may be clearly seen that his deeds have been wrought in God.
Joy again to be here and to share the worship here at Lafayette. Let us join together in prayer. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts together be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Our earth is growing. You've seen the pictures, I'm sure. The Haiti earthquake, the Puerto Rico earthquake, the St. Vincent volcano. The earth is literally moving under our feet, and we can't do anything about it except get out of harm's way. You and I have seen pictures of other events, glaciers calving too often, monster hurricanes forming, floods and winter storms and endless droughts, evidence that the earth is convulsing with climate change. Where can we find hope in these times? Where is the deliverance for creation promised in Romans chapter 8? Can we do something about our suffering earth? Can we model the love for the cosmos that Jesus offered? As the gospel reading says, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. That word world in Greek is cosmos. And our Christian faith truly includes all of creation in the salvation story. Yes, the good news of Jesus Christ tells us that the kingdom of God includes our fragile earth. Yet Christians in America should be embarrassed to confess that we had nothing to do with the founding of Earth Day on April 22nd, 40 years ago. We were too busy with other things in the 70s, social justice, mission, service opportunities. The earth was not our concern, although we appreciated the goodness of our home. With John Calvin, our first priority was the story of salvation. Earth was simply the stage, the setting for the divine drama played out for our benefit. We did not hear the groanings of our planet, but now we know better. I am happy to report that the modern Christian church has awakened to the groanings of Earth. Beginning in 1996, I have been witness to the changing attitudes of congregations and denominations across America. For 20 years in my role as the stewardship of creation educator for the Presbytery of Western New York, I saw congregations awaken to earth care. So now we have awakened to Apostle Paul's amazing teaching in Romans 8. Now we can hear him say that earth, God's good creation, is part of the story of salvation. It's not just about us. Paul says that the earth is groaning, aching, laboring, waiting with us for God's redemption. When God's people come out in public to declare the flowering of God's kingdom here on earth. Now we can say with the writer of John's gospel that God so loved the cosmos that God sent Jesus as Redeemer, bringing life to all, not to condemn the whole of creation, but to save all of the world, including humans and creation, from death and destruction. So here's the crux of the matter. What are we doing in response to God's good intentions for all of creation? Shall we care for all of creation, or shall we seek the kingdom for ourselves alone? Let me suggest to you that the whole of Paul's teaching in Romans 8 gives us clear guidance. In this passage, Paul is teaching about the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. The Spirit is our strength, our power, dwelling in our hearts. The Spirit of God, incarnate in us, teaches us what to do as we embody the coming kingdom of God on earth. The Spirit of resurrection of the risen Christ propels us forward, teaching us, showing us how God's good creation groans with us, yearning for release from bondage, hoping for new life. It is this Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, which moves us to include care for our groaning earth within our life together as people of God. And the Spirit gives us courage to identify ourselves clearly, to say out loud, we are followers of Jesus Christ, and as followers of Jesus Christ, we care for the earth because this is God's good creation. I am happy to report that many Presbyterians have been doing the good work of caring for God's creation. I commend to you the group Presbyterians for Earth Care, an eco-justice network started 25 years ago. The organization formed in response to the 1990 report adopted by the General Assembly of our denomination called Restoring Creation for Ecology and Justice. You can check them out at PresbyEarthCare.org, where they post updates to show how many of our congregations are doing the work of caring for creation. In addition, Presbyterians for Earth Care offers annual conferences and celebrates the work of individuals and congregations with awards. So, as part of our Christian identity, let us share in all the efforts to heal the earth, to relieve the groaning of creation, and rejoice in the beauty and bounty of this wonderful world. Let us declare that every day is Earth Day, just as every Sunday is a little Easter. Let us find opportunities in every neighborhood to renew the earth, from community gardens to farmers markets, from used clothing sales to local craft cooperatives, from seed and plant exchanges to long bike rides. Let us help with global and national efforts, such as filling the free pantry with nourishing food, pushing Congress to pass an effective climate energy bill, cooperating with Presbyterian disaster assistance to encourage sustainable living, and the list goes on. But this abundance of information is of no use unless we have the desire, through the power of the Holy Spirit, to ease the groanings of earth, to share in the creating work of God, to delight in the wonders of this beautiful planet as enthusiastic participants in the kingdom of God, renewing all of God's wondrous work. So come along with me. It's okay to care for creation. This too is part of the joyful work of the kingdom of God. As Paul says in Romans 8:31, since God is for us, who can prevail against speak of your glory in all the creation around us. We speak of your power in all of the earth. And we praise you that your Spirit is with us. Spirit of God, move among us. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Lord, we praise you. We tell of your wonderful works among us. Your amazing grace, your resurrection power that brings life where we thought life did not exist. Spirit of God, move among us. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Lord, we confess to you our complicity in the wrongs of this world, our eagerness to seek our own comfort at the expense of creation, our ignorance of how what we do and buy and store and keep affects all of good creation. Spirit of God, move among us. Lord, we petition you. We bring before you all those hurts and needs and desires and pains that have come to our attention. We bring to you those who are still mourning the loss of their loved ones due to the pandemic. We bring to you those who are dealing with incessant pain. We bring to you those who need your healing touch. And we bring to you our need to be present when people are hurting and to offer comfort. Because we know that your healing spirit is in our world, both in your creation and among your people. Spirit of God, move among us.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Lord, we thank you. We offer to you our gratitude for who you are, the triune God, Father, Son, and Spirit, Parent, Redeemer, Comforter. You made all that is, you sustain all that is, and you breathe life in all that is. And we thank you for this moment of communion with you here and now. Spirit of God, move among us.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We praise and thank you for the gift of life which you continue to give to us now and forever through your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
We have an offering time, and the people who are here in the congregation are certainly ready to make their offerings. We encourage those who are watching remotely to remember to make your offerings as well. So with gladness, let us return to God these offerings, the sacrifices of our lives, our labor, and our stewardship of the earth.
Thank you.
Thank you for that good word, Teresa. So we have taken the offering and we offer this prayer. Blessed are you, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have these gifts to share. Consecrate these offerings to be used for the glory of your name and in service to your kingdom. Amen. And now let me remind you that all of earth is part of God's good creation. And everything that we are doing, whether through the church or through other ways and means, honor the good creation that God has made. And now may the love of God, the Father, the Parent, the fellowship of God, the Son, the Redeemer, and the communion of God, the Holy Spirit, our Comforter, keep your hearts and minds and bodies renewed and refreshed, until we meet again, now and forever.